Hello viewers, today I shall explain LS and J coupling schemes. The objective of this talk is to facilitate you to learn about coupling and its types due to interaction between spin and orbital angular momenta of electrons. After learning this topic, you will be able to discuss interaction between the spin and orbital angular momenta of electrons. You will be able to define what is coupling and its types. You will be able to state the conditions at which these two couplings differ. Also, you will be able to realize the usefulness of these schemes. What is coupling? Coupling is the interaction between something. In atomic physics, what is coupling? Now, let us consider an atom having a single electron. We know this electron is revolving in an orbit around the nucleus. We know all rotating bodies will have angular momentum. So, this electron, due to its orbital motion, will receive an angular momentum called orbital angular momentum. This electron also has a spin motion. That means electron will spin about itself at the same time revolve around the nucleus in an orbit. So an electron in an orbit has two types of motion, orbital motion and spin motion. So both motions will contribute angular momentum to this electron. So what is the total angular momentum of this electron? Then we know it is the vector sum of the orbital angular momentum and the spin angular momentum. So it is very easy if the atom has single electron. But is there an atom having many electrons? So these electrons, each one will be revolving around the nucleus. Each one will be spinning about itself at the same time revolving around the nucleus. Some electrons will be spinning clockwise, some will be in the anti-clockwise. Now, if you want to find out what is the total angular momentum for this atom, it is not that easy. Okay, so we have to consider two kinds of atoms. One kind is light atoms, which are having less number of electrons. Another atom is heavier atom having more number of electrons. For example, this is a neon atom having electrons. If we consider uranium atom, it is still heavier having 92 electrons. Suppose if you want to find out what is the total angular momentum of all the electrons means, it is not at all easier job. So scientists have predicted two schemes by which you can find out the resultant angular momentum. The first scheme is called LS coupling. This type of coupling occurs for many light atoms. Light atoms means having lesser number of electrons. Now here, what you have to see? The interaction, the coupling between the orbital angular momentum and spin angular momentum of individual electron is weak, then the orbital angular momenta of the individual electrons add to form a resultant orbital angular momentum L. I hope you understand the difference. When you consider a single electron, the interaction between orbital angular momentum and spin angular momentum is weak. Then what you have to do to find out the resultant angular momentum? You have to find the vector sum of orbital angular momentum of all the electrons in the atom. Let L is the orbital angular momentum and L1, L2, L3, L4 are the orbital angular momenta of the four electrons respectively. First, let us consider an atom having two electrons. Let L1 be 1 and L2 be 1. Okay. When the coupling between the spin angular momentum and the orbital angular momentum is v for a single electron, then in that case, when you consider the atom with many electrons, what you have to do? We have to find out the vector sum of orbital angular momenta of each electron and find the resultant angular momentum, capital L. Now we have taken an example, L1 equal to 1, L2 equal to 1. Now, capital L, the resultant orbital angular momentum, can be expressed this way. L1 plus L2, L1 plus L2 minus 1, and finally you have to stop at L1 minus L2. You have learned the formula. Now you can substitute the values here. Okay. Now, capital L equal to 1 plus 1. So, 2. Next one. 1 plus 1, 2. Minus 1 gives you 1. Now, 1 minus 1, 0. So, your capital L can have 3 values. It could be 2, it could be 1, it could be 0. So, we have found out the total orbital angular momentum L of the electrons in an atom. Same way, what we have to do? We have to find out the vector sum of spin angular momentum of individual electrons in the atom to get the resultant angular momentum. As before, let S1, S2, S3, S4 represents the spin angular momentum of first, second, third and fourth electrons respectively. Now you consider two electron system. So let S1 equal to half and S2 equal to half. Like before, now we write the formula for resultant spin angular momentum S equal to S1 plus S2, S1 plus S2 minus 1, S1 minus S2. Okay. Now you substitute the values. Half plus half equal to 1. Now half plus half equal to 1 minus 1 resulting 0. Half minus half 0. So already one 0 is there. You need not write one more 0 here. The resultant spin angular momentum S will be taking the values 1 and 0. Now we know the resultant orbital angular momentum, resultant spin angular momentum. Now our task is to find out what is the total angular momentum. Total angular momentum could be expressed as J equal to L plus S. Now let us write the formula. L plus S, L plus S minus 1 until L minus S. Before doing the calculations, let us represent this kind of coupling with the help of a diagram. Okay? Now, we have considered two electron system. For the first electron, let L1 is the orbital angular momentum. For the second electron, L2 is the orbital angular momentum. Now, we have to find out the vector sum of L1 and L2 to find the resultant angular momentum L. So how to find out the vector sum of L1 and L2? Either you shift this here or you shift this here. I have represented as a dash line here. Now you can see vector and the other vector is starting and ending here. So vector sum of L1 and L2, simply it is represented by L here. Same way, we have to find out the vector sum of spin angular momenta of each electron. If S1 is in this direction and S2 is in this direction, you shift this here or this here and find out the vector sum. So this is the tail and the arrowhead. The second vector, tail and arrowhead. So, the resultant S is marked from here to here. So, we have resultant orbital angular momentum L in this direction, resultant spin angular momentum S in this direction. Right? Now, we have to find out what is total angular momentum. Once again, you find the vector sum of L and S. Okay? So, this L is shifted here so that this plus this gives you what is J. Or else you can say this S is shifted here. This vector sum of L and S gives you the total angular momentum of both electrons in an atom. This is the representation of LS coupling. So, all the orbital angular momenta of individual electrons added together to give a resultant orbital angular momentum. All the spin angular momenta of individual electrons added together to give resultant spin angular momentum. Next, the vector sum of L and S gives you the total angular momentum. Now, for example, we take L equal to 2, 1, 0 and S equal to 1, 0. In the earlier slide, we have calculated these values. Now, how to find out J? Now, you take 2, L as 2 and S as 1. So, use this formula. 2 plus 1 equal to 3. Next part of the formula is 2 plus 1 minus 1. So, you are getting 2. So, you have written. Next 1 is 2 minus 1 equal to 1. Okay. L is 2, S is 1, so 2 minus 1 is 1. Okay. Next, you consider the second value of L, 1, and the second value of S is 0. Now, substituting this formula, 1 plus 0 equal to 1, already 1 is written here. You need not write. Now, 1 plus 0 minus 1, it becomes 0. So, you write 0 here. Next to 1, you have 1 minus 0, that is 1 already it is there, you need not bother. Now take the last value, 0 plus 1, so already there, 0 plus 1, 1 is here, 0 minus 0 equal to 0 only. So you are having J values, 4 values, 3, 2, 1 and 0. Okay, so this is the way we have to find out the LS coupling. This kind of coupling is called LS coupling or Russell-Saunders coupling. Recall, this kind of coupling takes place only for lighter atoms having less number of electrons. And also, when the interaction between orbital angular momentum and spin angular momentum of individual electron is V, then what they do? All the orbital angular momenta of all electrons will be added to give a resultant angular momentum. And the spin angular momenta of all electrons add together to give resultant spin angular momentum. So, when the coupling between spin and the orbital angular momentum of individual electrons V, then this type of coupling is taking place. Okay. So, JJ coupling. This type of coupling occurs for many heavy atoms. Okay. Now, just the opposite of LS coupling you have to think of. Think. This type of coupling occurs when the interaction between the spin and orbital angular momenta of each electron is stronger than the interaction between the orbital angular momenta of all electrons or the spin angular momenta of all electrons. So, for each electron, if the interaction between the spin and orbital angular momentum is very strong, then this type of JJ coupling will be taking place. The orbital and spin angular momenta of each electron in an atom are added to obtain resultant angular momentum of the electron. Suppose the atom has some 3 electrons. For each electron, you have to find out the total angular momentum due to the vector sum of orbital and spin angular momentum of that electron. Okay. Now, you see, for the first electron, you can say J1 equal to L1 plus S1. For the second electron, you can say J2 equal to L2 plus S2. And so on. So, finally, what we have to do? The vector sum of all this total angular momentum will give you the resultant angular momentum of the atom. So this can be represented as vector J equal to sum of total angular momentum of individual electrons in the atom. So JJ coupling is that for each electron you have to find out what is total angular momentum. Then add all the total angular momentum of each electron to get the resultant total angular momentum. Now this can be expressed with the help of a diagram like this. Right. Let L1 is the orbital angular momentum of the first electron. And let S1 is the spin angular momentum of the first electron. Now, according to the concept of JJ coupling, for each electron, you have to find out what is the total angular momentum. So, L1 is in this direction, S1 is in this direction. So, this vector sum of L1 and S1 gives you what is J1. Okay. Next, you consider the second electron. If L2 is in this direction and S2 is in this direction, now what is the resultant of L2 and S2 you have to find out. That will be giving you the resultant angular momentum of the second electron. So you know what is the resultant angular momentum of the first electron and this second electron. Now if you find out the vector sum of these two, you will be getting the total angular momentum of the electrons of this atom. Okay. This way we have studied what is LS coupling and JJ coupling. Now we have to find out the applications. Now according to quantum theory, orbital angular momentum, spin angular momentum and total angular momentum are quantized both in magnitude and direction. And you know, each one will take, suppose L will take 2L plus 1 values, S takes 2S plus 1 values, J takes 2J plus 1 values respectively. While discussing the various quantum numbers, we have studied that orbital angular momentum can take values from minus L to plus L including 0, or we can say 2L plus 1, whereas spin angular momentum can take values from minus S2 plus S excluding 0, or you can say it is 2S plus 1. Same way, J can have values from minus J to plus J excluding 0. So thus we find that L, S, J can take values like this. Suppose if you consider the other three magnetic quantum numbers like magnetic orbital quantum number L. Now this can be found out like this. ML is equal to summation of MI. Suppose if there are so many electrons in the atom, for individual electron you have to find out what is magnetic orbital quantum number. Then for the second, for the third, fourth, then all of them together will give you ML. Next one, same way, MS equal to summation of MS and MJ equal to summation of MJ. Right? Like L, S and J, this ML, MS and MJ also can take value 2L plus 1, 2S plus 1 and 2J plus 1 values respectively. It is very easy to study the atomic spectra of various elements. Thus, LS coupling and JJ coupling are the very powerful methods to study the atomic spectra of elements. I hope you have understood and you have enjoyed this learning. Thank you, one and all.